Good morning, students. Our experiment today will be to identify acidic solution and alkaline solution. So I have taken few chemicals, or you can say indicators, with the help of which we can identify whether a given solution is an acidic or alkaline solution. So we can first start with an indicator called litmus solution. For this I have taken blue litmus. You can see this is blue litmus solution. Actually we have blue litmus paper also. I have taken blue litmus solution, and here we have a red litmus solution. Now you know that acid will turn blue litmus solution into red, and the red litmus solution will remain unchanged when acidic solution is added to it. So we are going to have that test, and for this I have also taken an acidic solution. Here I have taken hydrochloric acid. So I am going to add this hydrochloric acid to both the solution to find out if there is any change taking place or not. So first of all, I am going to start with the red litmus. So I will be adding acidic solution into this red litmus, and we are going to see whether it is going to bring about any change to this litmus solution or not. So here it is, acidic solution. I am adding slowly to it, and on adding we find there is no change in the color. So if there is no change in the color, it shows that the solution taken is acidic solution, because acidic solution does not affect the red litmus solution. Now we are going to do the same thing using the blue litmus. And you know that blue litmus should be changed to red. Let us try that. Now you can see here we have a blue litmus solution. Let us see whether any kind of change is coming into it or not on adding acidic solution to it. So here in the acidic solution I am going to add, and now you can see the color has been changed to red. So this confirms you that the solution taken is an acidic solution, which turns blue litmus solution to red, but there is no change in the red litmus solution. And next we are going to have one chemical test to show that the solution taken is an acidic solution. For this I am going to add sodium carbonate into the given solution, and you know that acid releases carbon dioxide gas when it reacts with sodium carbonate, and this carbon dioxide gas so released can be confirmed with the blue litmus paper. The acidic nature of carbon dioxide can be confirmed by taking the blue litmus paper, and it turns that blue litmus paper into red. So we are going to do that experiment now by adding sodium carbonate to that acid taken. So for this, what I am going to take to this acidic solution, I will be adding sodium carbonate, and the reaction will give out carbon dioxide gas, and when I bring this blue litmus on the mouth of the test tube where from carbon dioxide gas is released, this should be changed to red in color. That changing to red color indicates that carbon dioxide gas is acidic in nature. So we can try that. I have got a blue litmus paper also with me. I am now going to add sodium carbonate to this solution. So you can see I am going to add this sodium carbonate to this acid, and at the same time I'll gently be warming also, and you can see the bubbles and also the gas released. So let me first add So you can see the bubbles coming out, and now you can see that blue litmus has been changed to red color. So you can see one part of the blue litmus where it has come into contact with carbon dioxide gas has been changed to red color. So this shows that carbon dioxide gas is acidic in nature. But at the same time we have more taste of carbon dioxide gas, that it turns lime water milky. And in the next class I'll be showing you the alkaline solution. I'm going to taste that alkaline solution using the litmus solution, and also I'm going to perform one chemical test to confirm that the given solution taken is an alkaline solution. So I hope you have understood the experiment. This experiment is just to determine which given solution is an acidic solution or an alkaline solution. Thank you.